Why do I have SDS?
My daughter often asks me, imagine a world where SDS could just go away. Life could be normal and we could live without the fear that another shoe is gonna drop. How can we get there? As a molecular biology PhD, a biotech executive, and the mother of a sweet girl with SDS, I ponder this question every day. Shwachman-Diamond syndrome, or SDS, is a rare genetic disorder that affects many parts of the body. People with SDS face a high risk of bone marrow failure and leukemia, 30% by age 30. The current standard of care is to do bone marrow biopsies every year. The hope is to find pre-cancer clones early enough so that the progression toward leukemia can be stopped before it sets in, using bone marrow transplantation. However, biopsies often fail to identify bad clones, and bone marrow transplantation is a long, difficult process and can have life-threatening side effects. It's only used as a last resort. What if a new treatment could be developed to restore normal bone marrow function and eliminate the risk of bone marrow failure and leukemia in the first place? Such therapy would give us confidence that our kids' bone marrow results would be okay. Our kids wouldn't even need bone marrow biopsies anymore. If we had such therapy, we would no longer have to worry about leukemia. We could expect our kids to have a normal life. We could attend their graduations, dance at their wedding, and see their family grow. How wonderful would that be? How can we develop such a therapy? There are many different therapeutic approaches that could potentially get us there. The good news is that these approaches have been proven successful for several rare diseases. I won't attempt to read this out right now. Why isn't it available for SDS?
There are only a few thousand patients with SDS in the developed world, so pharmaceutical companies are not interested. Developing a therapy is a complicated process that requires different areas of expertise. It's like putting together a puzzle. We are very fortunate that several outstanding researchers and doctors have dedicated their careers to SDS. These researchers have started to put together the puzzle, but they alone cannot complete the entire picture. Many puzzle pieces have yet to be created, and those pieces require other experts with different areas of expertise. Why can't these other experts just help us?
The problem has to do with how medical research is funded. Before any research project can be started, a researcher has to apply for a grant from a funding agency, which in the US is primarily the National Institutes of Health. Applying for grants is a highly competitive process. The key to success is early data, because the data demonstrate that the research plan is likely to succeed and that the researchers have the ability to carry out the project. The problem with SDS research is that most researchers have never heard of SDS, let alone have sufficient data to get government grants. No data means no grant, and no grant means no data. It's a catch-22. As the patient community, we need to take action to overcome this challenge. We need to recruit additional experts to create the missing pieces for us. One strategy is to provide seed funding to highly selected experts and help them generate early data to get government grants and develop the missing pieces for us. We will also need to contract research institutions and companies to create essential tools for SDS therapy development. In addition, we have to organize the patient community to participate in research. Remember the successful therapies I couldn't pronounce? Every one of them is a direct result of these actions. Our actions matter. We hold the key to success. When we succeed, we will be free from the fear of leukemia or bone marrow failure. There is hope for our children's future,
As we figure out how to fix their bone marrow problems, we can also find better treatments for their other issues. But we have to act now, because leukemia can strike at any time. Will you join us?